innovations in love and sex in digital communications age, and probably all the games that we play was appropriate expression. Professor Christian Baku, the floor is yours.
Hello, good afternoon. I'm not a big expert in the subject I'm going to speak about. It is an occasional topic which we choose to dedicate our next semiotics school. I come from semiotics. That's why. That's why I will just put the accent on an overview how internet changed all these industries. Definitely, the result of the advent of internet in about love and sex changed, brought a cultural change, deep cultural change. It is object of semiotic study, how the structure of culture is changed. Here, I just want to outline some areas in which the most this impact of internet is most evident. So, the first big area, this is the cyber dating and hookup culture. After the internet, the hookup culture is something completely different. Internet made possible amazing combinations of forms of communication which help people to meet each other. There are some very strong statements that after the invention of marriage, Tinder is the second biggest change in human interaction, so, comparable with the marriage. There are also a big proliferation of identity games with this kind of, so there are profiled environments, platforms for meeting people, and a new variety of genders emerged and are encouraged by the possibility which the internet provides. The second big area, this is the way social media, their conventional form, when not explicitly dedicated to love and sex, nevertheless, they allow people to emphasize their sexuality in order to create their identity. So one new aspect of the online reality of our sexual and love relations is about the way social media allow us to create our identity, and this freedom of identity construction actually provokes many participants in the social interaction to emphasize very much on their sexuality. So a lot of things go on in on level of sexuality, even in conventional media, and this new terminology, which is sexting with sexual content, seems to be a very developed genre of communication nowadays, which without the internet would have never been possible. Okay, another industry, because economy has very much to do with all that I am saying. If we are going to understand the reasons of why all this is going on, probably the business drives will be the major ones. Nevertheless, we're interested on the consequences on culture. So, big business which transforms the way sexuality is monetized, internet, this is the webcamming industry, the hidden cams, and Mr. Skin is just a name of one website, very famous, showing sexual content from extracting only the sex scenes from movies, and seems that this website made a huge income, so now this is a bit a genre on the internet. So all this is the culture of voyeurism. Voyeurism has completely new dimension after the advent of the internet. All this, let's say, voyeuristic predispositions, which probably were repressed by the rules of society in the previous phases of development, even in Western society. Nowadays, with the internet, are unleashed. So there is a lot of voyeurism going on, and those are the ways it is monetized. Okay, now this is the classic. So probably for many people, when we say learning session on the internet, actually this is the porn websites. They are very famous. There was a kind of estimation, very famous in the first two decades of internet, that half of the internet is about porn. Now I try to find some more, let's say it's an updated statistic, probably 30% of the whole of the internet, 30%, this is a huge amount nevertheless, it is about erotic and pornography websites with incredible communication tools to make the difference. Actually, from particular semiotic interest are these short titles, verbal titles of the videos, the video clips in porn sites, which in a way try to link our everyday experience with what is the content of the movie. So this is just one invitation for content analysis, the verbalization. Okay, another area of deep cultural change, of deep change of habits, of how sexuality and okay, in this occasion probably love is not the proper thing. This is how the internet helped sex workers to become more independent. Actually, prostitution assumed a new polarization after the advent of the internet. So a lot of so-called sex workers nowadays, thanks to the internet, are completely outside the crime sector, outside criminality. And on the contrary, those whose cultural capital is not enough, and mostly from the third world sex workers, their condition is much worse than it used to be before, because now this be online or be offline brought this split. So those who remained offline, probably they are even more endangered today and in more criminal situations, more exploited by the old-fashioned crime type of monetization of sex work, rather than those who are online. So many more men and women nowadays sell sexual services, sexual performance in big, because the internet gives very sophisticated ways to participate in the way you would like to participate. And actually the websites helped people to combine this kind of activity with normal job, with normal existence. Digitally engineered sex, another universe. Robots. Do you know what teledildonics means? It was a new term for me, very interesting. So, kind of tools which.
What was that word again?
Teledildonics. So, for me, it was new. This is like a device which helps people being on a huge distance, for instance, in Japan and in the United States, to make sex in a synchronized way, to use their movements to transfer their. So, very, very innovative things. Sex robots. One of my PhD students recently shared news on the everyday things which happen in that. So, a guy cut the head of a sex doll because this sex doll, sex robot, was laughing at his genitals. So he just destroyed the doll. He projected his emotional frustration to a doll. So apparently this industry producing human-like machines, perfect lovers, are involving people in a very complex way. You know, it's logical. And last but not least, just a second, digital engineer at six. Okay, here I, this was the picture for the digital engineer at six. And last but not least, and I'm very well with the time.
Is it teledildonics called?
I have to go. So, the revenge porn, the so-called, this is the dark side of another culture which was not existent before. So try to think of this very often. When people split, now internet, social media, YouTube or other channels become extremely powerful and dangerous tool for revenge. For instance, the abandoned, offended partner of the couple can't publish, can make public, for instance, videos which were taken in intimate moments with the partner during their relationship. There are not one cases of people suicides because of this very, very mean way. But also, internet gave a new dimension of the abuse with children, the way pedophilia is now exercised, and a lot of negative uses of the internet. So, trauma studies are now about to be done strictly for the way internet changed through this dark side. And who wants to know more? This is our semiotic school in September. If you want to have more information, infosociosemiotics.net. There we will be more advanced in our research. For the moment, it's just an overview.